So now, chef, tell me, where are we up to with our crispy pizza, which is not a pizza, as you keep telling me, but that's what we're calling it.
As I said, I prepared some beef carpaccio in the top of this crunchy pizza, and I put some rocket on the top. And now I'm trying to give you some flavor. As we said, we put some truffle oil before.
So you're just drizzling that over the top?
On the top, and I'm finished with some grana padana riserva. It's from Italy. Just to complete, I'm going to vitel tornato. It's a crispy pizza on the top of with some veal. And I prepare some sauce now front of. Is anchovies.
So that one's going on the base of the next piece.
That just looks so good. That looks so good. I mean, also the flavors are bold. You're talking about bold flavors, and that will kickstart the appetite. And when you serve this as an appetizer, you're telling people, start your palates and you're going to eat. It's a feast.
Tell me, what are we doing next? What are you preparing for us?
The next two biting will be one gambero rosso from Sicily with some lime and quinoa, puff quinoa. And the second bite, there will be a tuna with some avocado in crispy puff rice. I will just put some olive oil, salt, nothing else. It's just, this is what is important to do. If you have a nice product, you don't have just you have to just mix, put a lovely salt. In this case, we use Maldon salt. It's a good product that comes from England. Mm-hmm. And olive oil from Dima. Thank you for that. And I forgot to bring my oil. And we do some crunchy on there, and simple as that. The second one will be tuna. We just season it with some shallots and some anchovy paste, some salt again, and olive oil, and chives. Simple as that. Now, the funny things of that one, you know, we are preparing as rice, saffron rice. Usually when you overcook the rice, you get a complaint. To prepare this one, we need to overcook the rice, and we need to start to dry up. And
it looks like a cracker.
It's a cracker, but it's not, as you said, we try to make a light because, you know, and just we put on the top.
So you're putting that into the, nesting it into the cracker.
And just we put some kind of Asian, we put some avocado on the top. A couple of years ago, it was very difficult to try to serve this dish in Italian restaurant.
I want you first to taste the oil like I gave you in the pot, smell it, and then just take in the aroma, and then take a taste of the plain oil so you can get the flavors of the oil. Then try it with the bread. You got the pickled za'atar here, and you're gonna get the goat's milk labneh now. Try the za'atar on its own. This is pickled. It's like oregano, but it's the Arabic version of oregano. It's called za'atar. And then try the za'atar with the labneh as well. And this is the kind of simple food that we like to get together and just, you know, break bread together and eat together and have a great time. Food for gatherings.